I think I can speak on behalf of all the young ladies and all the women that participated in the Cash and Rocket Tour 2014 that we are all so proud, not only of ourselves, but proud of everyone who's donated money to our cause, donated money to the three and amazing charities, because we all know that this money is going to go towards helping three amazing NGOs in Africa. It's an amount of pride that, you know, we hopefully will take with us, and we'll come back next year and do the same, triple it.
Of course, life on the road is always eventful. Were there any particular incidents as you were traveling across Europe?
Well, I got lost a few times. GPS doesn't always work in foreign countries, but you know what? It's not about the loss of GPS. It's about making sure you find your way to the finish line, and that's what we did today, and I'm super proud. Of course it's empowering. I mean, we wore shirts that said empower. I mean, because that's what it's about. It's women, you know, not sitting around waiting for someone to come and, you know, and address the issues at hand. We're strong women, and we can drive fast cars. We could drive four cities in 4 days and endure every obstacle and overcome it because we're resilient and we're fierce and we're, you know, we're doing it for other women and other children that we've never met before. But it doesn't matter because it's all about empowering them. So it was an amazing experience.
People do want to give more money. Where can they go for more information about how to give, donate?
They can definitely go to cashandrocket.com, or they can go to their individual charity websites. So shineonsierraleone.org, sambadilla.org, or orphanaid.org.
You mentioned they're the three fantastic charities. Can you just tell us a little bit more about that for people who aren't familiar with the wonderful work they do?
Well, they're all based in they're all based in Africa. Shine on Sierra Leone, we support children and women. We provide microloans, education, child mortality is a big issue in Sierra Leone. It's the highest in all the world. 1 in 8 women die at childbirth. 1 in 4 children die before the age of 5. Education is something that every child should experience. We're very proud to, after this event, we're very proud to be building our secondary school so that the children of Kono don't have to travel miles and miles and miles in the rain and the treacherous rain, and they can be close to their families, and they don't have to worry about being kidnapped or run over or raped and any of those things that no child should ever worry about. They should be focused on their education. Orphanaid speaks for itself. Orphanaid, they go into supposed orphanages and rescue children who are being sold into slavery or orphans or, you know, any type of abusive orphanage. They provide, you know, an education, well-being. They help reunite the families, and Sambadilla, I'm not so sure I'm pronouncing it correctly, please forgive me. It's all about education. It's all about educating the children, providing environments that are safe and sound. At the end of the day, I think all three of these NGOs are all about just providing safe environments for these children so they can grow up to become, you know, well-rounded individuals.